Hello everyone and welcome to RTC TV4. My name is Galen Rensselaer, here with Dakota Hayden.
How's it going, folks?
We are here at the Caston Crater getting ready for an awesome night of football as it's homecoming for the Comets.
And I'm all turned up here. I'm ready to go. We're excited to get this started.
We're about to get everything here started as we prepare for the kickoff. Caston sets up as to receive the ball. Of course, Miami will be kicking the ball off. KCO and Blake Albright back to receive. That ball is going to go to KCO, and he's going to catch it up to the 10, the 15, up to the 20, 22, back to the 20.
Push back.
And he is brought down.
They're going to spot it at the 23-yard line.
That was all right. That was all right. We can work with that.
They'll start out with the ball on the 23-yard line.
It's okay. We can work with that.
They're playing the undefeated Warriors here at the Crater.
But however, the claim in the locker room is that the North Miami has not played a decent team all year, so they're thinking they can pull out a win here tonight.
Yeah, we'll see what happens as they start the first play of the game here. Junior quarterback, Brady Hartman, as the quarterback. Handoff play to KCO, and he's brought down right at the 24-yard line. Picked out one on the rush.
Stop in there, number 74.
A gain of yards is a gain of yards. That'll work.
Second down, Comets.
It will be second down here for the Comets with 9 yards to go. Conrad is coming in for the game for Tate Cal.
The Comets figuring out a strategy here, heading up to take up the offensive again.
Conrad goes out to the right receiver spot as we have KCO as the running back. Tate Cal's coming across. Handoff play. The all is brought down and picks up two on the hands off there. Bumps him up to the 26-yard line with now force third down here.
Gonna have to get a few more yards than that if we're gonna make any progress here tonight.
It was interesting. I was talking to a couple of players and how their passing game has been going the past couple of games, and I asked if, you know, because when they pass it when they're down in formation, it doesn't give the junior quarterback Brady Hartman enough time to look for a guy open.
Right.
So I asked him, well, how come they never, you know, never go into a shotgun play to give Brady a little bit more time, and they say they don't have the snap to do it. I said, I thought that was pretty interesting, because I mean, it's not that hard to snap the ball.
Not necessarily.
Back to quarterback.
But when it comes to anything, there's always a technique for it.
Yeah.
So I guess if it's not their strong suit, then why go for it?
Yeah, that could be it. But
they got to be careful here, because North Miami seems to favor a triple option whenever they go on the offensive.
Yeah,
so we're going to see how we're going to counter that.
I heard that from Coach Jones this week, head coach for the Comets. They're punt the ball off. Phoenix Singleton.
Nice
if they would look up, number 77.
Comets down the football at the 50-yard line where the North Miami Warriors will start first and 10.
All right, shifting things off to the Warriors taking the offensive.
And the Warriors will start the ball off on the 50-yard line right at the middle.
We go setting up.
Handoff play. He's up to the 40, 45, gets up to a 45 yard line.
That's going to rear up the first down for North Miami.
It's down to the 35 yard line and first down for the Warriors.
It's a nice run play by him.
And I'll play once again to the fullback, number two for the Warriors.
And he is wide open.
And he's going down to the 20, about to the 15-yard line. And that's going to bring up a first down for the Warriors.
That was a fumble. I think he fumbled it.
Down inside the
20-yard
line at the 15.
It looked like he did.
First down for the Warriors.
Too bad, though.
Gets him to the 15-yard line. Another handoff play to number 18, the other fullback. And he's up to the almost 10-yard line.
18, Trevor Lynn on the carry.
So far, I've been able to get him down as they got yards gaining, but it's not good how many yards they're gaining.
Smith and Howard.
Seem to be pushing through just a little bit too easy.
First and goal to go for the Warriors from the 2-yard line.
Ball will actually be on the 2-yard line on that one. And I'll play it once again, and that's stopped by number three, Phoenix Singleton comes down, comes out with the tackle.
Second down, Warriors.
Nice. Helmet's got to hold him back here. Can't let him score a touchdown early on. Setting up for another offensive play on Miami.
And off play. Looks like, I think they're going I think he got in on that one, maybe.
Nope.
Okay, no.
Just barely keeping him out of the end zone.
I couldn't see who was on the tackle. I think Trent Howard was kind of in the mix of that. Number 53, Trent Howard, as known as the Ginger Milkshake.
I love that nickname.
And I'll play once again. And he's
still stopped.
Touchdown, yes.
He's able to just make it.
Kind of looked like he got stopped again, but I guess he snuck in there and got the ball across the line while he was up.
That's okay, that's okay. Make that the only score that they get. They're looking for the extra point here.
88 Hanaway to attempt the extra point.
And that's going to look good.
It is good. Warriors 7, Con 0.
A little bit of a rough start here tonight, but nothing we can't shake off.
A key player for the Comets that is not playing. Actually, two players for the Comets. Key players that would not be playing this game is number, which number is Ethan and Mosquito?
21.
The running back. He would not be playing for the Comets as the home opening game. He got injured Thursday night in practice with a shoulder injury. So he will be out until it heals up. Right now, he has it crippled right now. And then the other player, number 35,
Colt Walker,
he is also injured with a knee. I'm not sure what the whole problem is with that. I think he might have just sprained it, but no, he can't sprain it. A knee, my bad.
No.
But
I'm not sure about Colton, but it's unfortunate for Ephraim. But
he's been limp. Go ahead.
For his safety, though, because he suffered a really bad, I think it was like a shoulder injury or something like that, that if he would have kept using that arm, he could have ended up paralyzed in there. So
wow.
he's got to be able to sit that out so that way, because he wanted to continue with wrestling this year.
Yeah, most definitely, because his Ephraim's huge sport in wrestling. He's a three-sport athlete, plays football and wrestling in the winter, and then does baseball in the spring. So hopefully he'll get that healed up, because I'm looking forward to playing with him this spring.
I'm looking forward to get more film of him.
So hopefully that'll heal up. So the Comets are down by two players this game.
That's okay. We got plenty of great players out there that should be able to make amends for that.
All right, let's see what the Comets can do here on their second position of offense. Take out coming over, handoff play to Casey Ault.
Nice gain of yards.
Oh, it stops right at the 31-yard line, maybe.
He's across the 30 to the 32-yard line.
32.
All right.
Second down Comets.
Picked up two on the handoff.
So far, been pretty decent at gaining yards here on the offense, but not enough to get us to the first down.
Yeah. I mean, they're not a bad running team. I mean, they're hitting the ball off 9 out of 100%. They do about, I'd say 90% is half the time, you know, running. As you see, a handoff toss to Casey Alt once again. Casey
Alt's like he's got, oh, he had an opening. They closed pretty fast.
Might have picked up another 2 yards on the game.
He's back to the line of scrimmage. Third down, Comets.
Nope, he didn't move anywhere.
Be here, third down for the Comets with 8 yards to go. Hopefully, let's see what they'll do here with the, hopefully a pass play. And as you see, junior quarterback, he's scrambling, he's getting down. Not much of a play there.
No. But there was an attempt there.
It's back up to the line of scrimmage. Stop made by number 50, Brett Kimes.
Now for us, fourth down here for the Comets.
4-7, it looks like we're setting up to kick it back off to the Warriors.
Back to punt for the Comets is number 3, Phoenix Singleton.
It's up.
It looks like he's scrambling. He's going for it. You know?
Oh, there's okay. The kick.
And they're going to let that. They're going to touch it right at the 38-yard line.
Chris Smith.
That was a nice kick by Phoenix.
38-yard line. For the Warriors will start first and 10. Don't forget the Red Barn Elephant here. Trailer is down there and ready to go and operating. I just saw somebody carry one in. Looks good. Number 2, Eck Road on the carry, stopped by Casey Alton and Trenton Howard. Second down, Warriors.
So you continue. You probably have a basketball.
Briggs on a quarterback keeper. Slipped down by Alton. Stopped by Howard and Powell. Third down, Warriors.
Not making a
18.
Down for the Warriors.
Trevor Lynn on the carry. Stop made by 53. Trenton Howard for the Comets, but not until he gets the first down for the Warriors.
This isn't good. I don't like how the Warriors have been pretty effective in getting those first downs. That's only the start, so.
Oh, fake handoff.
Going for a pass.
Going for 80, number 81.
And that's complete, and he's way out there. That'll make it a touchdown for North Miami.
Number 81, Lucas Harrison, for a touchdown for the Warriors.
That will be a touchdown for the Warriors. What a great fake handoff. And then goes back for the pass and finds number 81, wide receiver, for the touchdown.
I'll be honest, that was a nice play. Now they're setting up for that extra point.
Can't wait to attempt the extra point.
Kicks, I think
kick is good.
Kick is good. Warriors 14, Comets 0.
about 5 minutes into the first quarter. Not all hope is lost. We've trailed behind by much, much more in previous games, so there's at least a good chance that we can come back here. Get into it. North Miami set up to kick it back off to the Comets. And pretty nice looking kick by North Miami.
As KCO drops it, picks it right back, but he's off to the 24.
Oh, he's got an opening.
Up to the 30, and stopped right at the 31.
He had a really nice opening there.
Comets will start the ball on the 31-yard line. Let's see what they can do this time. Hopefully they can get some yards here. See if they can pick some yards up.
Nice if we can get a touchdown here in the first quarter so we're not trailing too far. Handoff play. He's caught early.
He's brought down right at the... I think he might have... I don't think he picked up any yards on that one.
I don't think so.
Shot made by that rope.
No, wait. 1 yard. Picked up 1 yard. 1 yard. A yard is a yard. We're good.
There we go. Second down for the Comets. 9 yards to go. And off play once again, and it's to Blake Albright.
Ooh. Hey.
I think he might have lost 1 yard on the game.
Might have. Looked like he got picked up there. Yeah, about 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. Comets got to pull something out of their sleeves here to get through the, so far, seemingly impressive North Miami defense.
Third down here, handoff play once again, and it's to KCO. And now it's gonna force fourth down there. Again, I mean, I don't get the play calling, honestly, for the Comets. When it's third down, and 9 yards to go, I mean, you gotta go for a pass.
Yeah, you think.
I mean, in the last three positions of offense, I mean, they've already had three, and that's all they've done is pass, and I mean, is, excuse me, run. Especially on third down like that. I mean, you just got to go for it.
I have no idea what they're planning on here or what their strategy is, but
I just don't understand that.
Seems repetition is key here.
Ooh.
Phoenix looking to lob off on the North Miami kids' heads. That was close.
I don't know if it's serious. It looks to me that the Comets just look really tired. Just kind of jogging around. I mean,
I'm not sure. They better get their heads in the game soon.
Yeah. I'm not sure what's up, but
as a fact,
hopefully it'll get picked up during halfway the game. But sometimes you can't wait till it's, you know,
right.
And you don't have enough time to come back.
You got to pick up the leverage soon.
Yeah.
But there is a fact here. As long as I've been in high school anyway, the Comets have not won a single homecoming game.
Wow.
So I'm hoping to change that.
I guess I've never noticed that or heard.
At least I'm pretty sure the past 4 years.
Past 4 years then, huh?
Yeah.
40
Casey Alabama stopped with up from 53 Trent Howard. Second down Warriors.
Let's see. This will be a turnaround point, at least for my senior year. handoff play at North Miami, and he's way out there. Number 7, Tate, catch
up
him.
Up to the 20, the 10, and he's in for the touchdown.
18,
turn around for
the touchdown to the Rose.
This isn't good.
This is not good.
We're already trailing pretty far behind. Miami's setting up for that extra point.
Can't wait to attempt the extra point.
Man, that's looking good.
That'll put the Warriors up 21-0 as the Comets trail with 2 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the first quarter.
Not liking this trailing. I'm still pumped up. I think we can come back. I know we can. And the Comet crowd getting excited here tonight.
Trying to get a wave going on here.
And so far, Mike and Paul initiating the wave was pretty successful, getting them all riled up here. Spark up enough energy for us to make a comeback here. No plan, be lining up to kick it back off to the Comets as we're rearing the end of the first quarter here.
KCL looks to receive the ball up to the 15, 20, 22, 25, 30. To the 30.
35.
He's still pushing through up to maybe 37-yard line.
Nice.
Let's see what the Cubs can do with this as Casey Oak does a great job getting the ball all the way up to the 37-yard line.
He's definitely a prime player for the Cubs team. Nice. Now let's push enough yards to make a touchdown here before the first quarter ends.
Looks like Conrad, number 12, is over and fills in for the right receiver as they hand the ball off to Blake Albright. He's brought right down on the play.
Didn't get too much leverage.
Blake Albright on the carry. No gain on the play. Second down, Comets.
Less than, actually about 1:30 left on the clock for the first quarter. Down to second, 8 yards to go.
Ball on the 38-yard line for the Comets. Handoff play to Blake, number 2.
Oh, was that?
No, Blake? That is not Blake.
Number 2.
I'm not sure who that is. I think it might be Isaiah Conrad.
Miles McDonald.
He actually came on and said he would join the team a little late. Decided to join, and Comets are really thankful to have him on the squad. So
nice. Nice attempt at a run there by Miles. Again, third
down here, and actually looking for a pass this time. He tosses it up to Conrad.
Number 12.
Oh!
Conrad so close there.
With one hand. Couldn't bring it down.
It was there. It was in the palm of his hand. He just couldn't.
Hey, you know what? I'm really excited that they actually went for a pass play on third down.
That was nice. That was nice. Just couldn't get it there. Man.
Hartman's pass was intended for Conrad was incomplete.
Looks like they're going to kick it back off there.
For the Comets, number 3, Phoenix Singleton to punt. 25, Dakota Rivera.
I think this goes through the punt. Straight up.
And I'm not sure what number 3, Phoenix Single, is trying to achieve as he runs over to the right side of the field and he punts it off.
I'm not sure.
I don't get the point of that, honestly. I don't know why he would just punt the ball off to
Warriors.
Well, everybody has against it because the sooner or later, I feel like the Warriors, one of the defense guys, are going to come get him. They're actually going to get that tip.
Well, there's got to be some strategy behind it, I'm sure. Do that, he's just trying to throw them all off.
Yeah. But, I mean, he's done that for the, I mean, straight for a time.
True. We're just trying to mix it up a little bit.
Yeah. Most definitely. Always good. Ain't off play, and he, fumble on the play.
Fumble on the play. We'll see who comes out with the football.
Who's got it?
They're saying second down, so the Warriors recover.
Warriors recovered that fumble. 15 seconds left on the clock for the first quarter.
Loss of a yard on the play, second down Warriors.
Setting up for the final play of this quarter.
And now we're through it. And that's going to end it for the first quarter. Thank you all for watching R2C TV. We'll be right back with you in the upcoming quarter. Thanks.
King and Queen candidates out on the field and announce our 2016 homecoming King and Queen.
Entering the second quarter now. The Comets still trailing by 21. Let's see.
Honestly, I actually felt like the first quarter went really fast compared to the other 2 weeks.
It did. It did seem like it went fast. Handoff play by North Miami. Brought down.
Southern Chain holding on the carry. One to run on the pitch.
Might have gained the yard.
Shot by Howard and Singleton. Third down for the Warriors.
Setting up again. That's right. Handoff. He's way over.
Nope. Gets up to the 40. He's brought down by number 54.
54. I'm not really so sure. Wesley. That's Wesley, number 54.
Wesley, number 54.
Go home and memorize the player numbers.
Oh, false start there. Ooh.
Number
54, did you see Wesley?
Yeah,
Wesley goes right through and brings down the quarterback.
Just straight up speared him.
Defense off sides. 5 yard walk up gives the Warriors a first down.
And he kept going after him once they called the whistle.
Not so sure what that was about, but
pass play here by the Warriors. Looking, gets it.
Oh, we got it.
That pass is complete and brought down at the 19-yard line.
Briggs' pass is complete to Lynn. Stop made by Alt and Cowell. First down for the Warriors.
I will say the Warriors are doing a pretty decent job of gaining yards here, but the Comets defense needs to strengthen up here. We can't let them score any more than they, just anymore. Looks like it was a handoff play, but it's taken down.
Picked up by Alt and Slocum. Second down for the Warriors.
Warriors seem to be inching up closer every time. We got to keep them back. So
Okay, another handoff play, and he stopped real quick.
Number 7, Holman on the carry. Stop made by 3, Beating Singleton. Loss of a yard on the play. Third down for the Warriors.
Nice. We have a push him back a yard. Every little bit helps. It'll be here. Third down for the Warriors. 10 yards to go. Ball is placed at the 21-yard line. They're setting up. Oh, that looks like another false start by number 72, I think.
72.
I'm not so sure.
Third and 5 for the Warriors.
It's like I can picture his face, but I can't.
Apologize. Numbers just seem to be leaving me here tonight. Timeout is called, and we're going to take a short break while the duration of that goes through. And here we are, welcome back.
We're here, third down for the Warriors. Scramble pass, ooh, he looks like he slipped, and that brings him down.
That's gonna bring up fourth down here for the Warriors. It's nice for the Comets to keep him pushed back. Hopefully they can take up the offensive here and just start scoring some points. Looks like the Warriors are still going for it in the fourth.
Oh, incomplete pass. That's going to force fourth over. That's going to force turnover on down.
15-yard line.
Turnover on down.
Nice. Connor's back on the offensive, and hopefully we can get it in for a touchdown. It's seemingly putting up a strategy here. Kind of hoping they go for another pass play. They seem to almost have it there. If Conrad would have just had a better grip on the ball or was able to bring it down.
Yeah, most definitely. I'm hoping that they... Hey, it looks like a fumble.
Yeah. Nice.
Not sure, recovery. But looks as if the there's like some kind of white thing thrown out into the field. I'm not. Do you see that, Dakota? Okay, it looks like maybe a... I'm not sure what that was.
I don't know either. At least we were able to recover that fumble, though. It would have been bad if we lost it right there.
And here we go, that's pass play set up. Brady's going deep to Conrad.
Launched it out there. And Conrad's got it this time. Nice.
Conrad.
Nice. That'll be first down for the Comets. It was a nice catch by Conrad.
Wow, there we go. Like I said, they need to pass the ball more.
That worked. That worked real well.
Yes, it did. Indeed. Really excited for the Comets because actually I think that's their first big pass play of the year.
That actually went through, yeah. I do believe you're right.
It's kind of weird to say, but
yeah,
it's true.
All right. Now we're cooking.
Ball will be placed on the 50-yard line. Hand off to number 40, KCO.
Ooh, and he's getting pushed back there.
40 KCO, on the carry.
Shot by 52, Garrett Feeney, and 2, Jeff Eckler. Second down Comets. Loss of a yard on the play.
Second down. There's about 8 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Comets can get another good play in here. We might be looking at a touchdown here.
Yeah, 13 seconds.
Takeout is coming across. Number 4 hands off the KCO, and he's brought down. Maybe a loss of yard right there on the play.
Maybe you try something.
Might have been.
Might have
been.
40 KCO on the carry.
All right, well, thank you for tuning in to RTC TV 4. We'll be right back after this short break. Back to RTC TV 4 here in the second quarter with seven and a quarter minutes remaining.
Ooh, going for a pass.
The Carter
pass it again. Nice.
Looks like the junior number 20 quarterback Hartman tosses it off to number 30 KCL, and KCL goes for the pass.
That was awesome.
To Conrad, first down. That is complete. Ooh. That's going to put him on the...
I'd say about the...
29 yard line here. As we start with the first down and 10 yards go for the Comets.
All right. Looking good. It's looking good.
Handoff play to all.
And he had just enough room to get there.
Up to the 18-yard line. 19. Okay, let's go.
Nice, nice, nice.
Conrad's coming back into the game for the freshman number 82, Hunter Shalob. Really excited to see him get some playing time.
Now it's sitting up here, sitting down with 5 yards to go.
It's kind of funny if you see the matchup on Conrad and Warrior. It's a really little guy, and Conrad's about 6'4".
Yeah, 6'4".
And the guy that's played defense on him is about almost maybe 5'4". I don't know.
Penalty
against the Comets. Maximum 5 yards.
We had some momentum, but. Yeah, back us up a few yards. All right. I do believe it's 3rd and 10. Or 2nd and 10. My bad.
Hand off play, though. Number 40, Casey Owens.
And he is wide open there. Go!
Up to the 10.
And that's a first down to the guard line.
A great offensive run right there for the Comets.
That was nice. The Comet crowd getting riled up here tonight. It's a nice place.
From the 9-yard line.
Go!
setting up pass play.
Brady Harvey's going deep.
Conrad out there. And, oh! Wasn't good. Incomplete pass.
It's great play, though.
That was a good play. That was real close. Comet's going to be second and nine. You're going to figure something out here. They're so close.
Pass play again. Brady Hartman finds incomplete, but number 81 for the Warriors almost got a hold of that.
That was just a bit nerve-wracking.
Didn't want to see that good position of offense turn into
all those good plays turned into an interception there. Well, that is the risk when going for pass plays. Always the opportunity for the opposing defense to intercept it. Thomas, 39.
Pass play once again.
Oh,
and he's brought down.
He just couldn't get any ground there.
Back to the 13-yard line. Fourth down for the Comets.
This will be fourth and 13. They gonna go for it. They gonna punt it back.
I think they're only. I mean, they can't punt the ball on their 13.
Oh yeah, true. Yeah.
I think.
They'll
have to pretty much go for it or take the risk and kick the field goal. But almost every time they score in the past couple games, they just go for it.
Yeah.
I think they don't really have any good field goal kickers.
Yeah, I'm not so sure on that one. Well, they ended up calling a timeout. So thank you all for tuning in, and we'll be right back with you.
Kids to Galore Kindergarten in first grade, second, third, four, five, and six, seven, and eight. And we'll show you how to putt. Don't forget to see the cheerleader table down there. They'll be down there through halftime tonight. A ticket to win a basket full of great items. The Caston themed basket is full of items for Comet fans. Community basket offers something for everyone, from Visa gift cards, services from community businesses, shirts, hats, and more. Together, the baskets have over a $500 value. Tickets are $2 each or three for $5. And the funds go towards the Citrus Bowl performance trip for the cheerleaders.
All right, and we're back. About 5 minutes left on the second quarter. Comets 4 and 13.
I was going for it here. Harden looking.
Looking.
Fumble. That's going to be a turnover on down.
Quarterback keeper.
They just had him swarm.
Comets not enough for a first down. The Warriors will take over at the 11-yard line.
It looks like Warriors are going to regain offense. That's a shame. We were real close there to scoring. We had momentum going, but that got seemed to be turned around on us. Oh, North Miami taking the offense. They got a bit of distance to cover themselves, so hopefully the defense, our defense line should be able to hold them. Handoff. And he is way out there.
Out to the 30. 40. Crosses up and he goes out of bounds, and that's going to be stopped at the 45-yard line.
Number 40, Casey, number 3, Phoenix, are able to just push him out.
The 47-yard line, first down for the Warriors.
Comets need to watch him. North Miami just feeding off of those open runs. Miami setting up, handoff.
He's up to the 50.
Open there.
The 40. Up to the 30.
Look at him go.
Oh. I'd say he's brought down by the 20. Warriors running game has been quite effective here in this first half.
Yeah.
I haven't really seen him pass that much except for that touchdown play to that fake handoff play into the pass for the wide receiver, number 81, for the touchdown. Besides that, I mean, their running game has been really, really effective. They use it to their full advantage here.
Gotta hand it to them. It's gonna be a pretty rough game here tonight. Looks like it was a handoff. He was swarmed.
There's a quarterback keeper brought down by Howard and Dillon. Second down for the Warriors.
Now put second and eight for the Warriors. Hopefully the defense can keep them back here. We don't need them to score again.
Fake handoff.
It was fine. Pass and two. Caught.
And that is good for the first down.
Virginia's pass is complete to number two, Echo. First down for the Warriors inside the 10-yard line. First and goal to go for the eight.
This isn't good.
Right guard did not get that.
This isn't good.
Was getting down on the
60, Mark Smith, and on the stop for the Comets. Coleman on the carry for the Warriors.
Being a second down for the Warriors with 5 yards to go. The ball is placed on the 5-yard line. Handoff play.
He's brought down.
I think he lost some yards right there on the play.
Nice. We can keep pushing him back. It's going to be real good for us. Third and nine for the Warriors. This is the handoff. He was brought down pretty quick.
Eckert on the carry. Shot by number 16, Mark Smith. Dirk Howard. Warriors.
4-9 for the Warriors with about 2 minutes left to go here in the second quarter. Here they go. They went for a field goal attempt and they got it.
Warriors 24, Comets 0.
They got one heck of a kicker there on their team.
Got 1 minute and 54 seconds remaining here in the second quarter.
And we'll be rearing into halftime where for homecoming, we'll figure out who our homecoming king and queen is for Caston. If I remember right, our last voting nominees were, for Queen, there was Courtney Fry, Alyssa Hubenthal, I think Ellie Kay, and I'm pretty sure for King, there was Carlos Estrada, Trenton Howard, and Micah Paul.
Micah Paul, okay.
So we'll see who wins.
That explains why Carlos Estrada is really dressed out, because I just seen him walking by.
Yeah.
He's all spiffed up, looking great.
I'll be interested to see who wins for that. Miami lining up to kick it back off for the Comets here.
Looks like Blake Albright's going to get that one.
He is put down roughly 36, 37 maybe yard line.
44 Zach Slocum fields that kick and returns it upfield to the 36-yard line where the Comets will start first and 10.
All right. Let's gain some yards here before we hit halftime. Maybe even a touchdown if we're lucky. Yeah.
the Warriors do get ball at the half, right?
I think so.
Yeah, they kick the ball off.
My bad. Or pass to number 7, Tate Cowell. He's put down right at the 40.
Number 7, Tate Cowell to the 40-yard line. Three second down comments.
That was a nice short pass there. Comets lining up.
Pass or pass.
Number 86, I believe that's James Keel.
Perfect pass is complete to number 86.
And that'll be a good gain of yards.
10 games of the new Western Comets. First down!
That's going to be first down for Comets. Nice.
And they called, oh no, I thought they called a timeout because of time clock, but they didn't.
No, we're good. We're good.
They got to try to score here before halftime. Pass play once again.
Good pass.
Looking for Conrad. Conrad floats it up. That's going to be intercepted.
Oh, no. No. Get him. That's not. He is open. We'll bring him down. Number 69, Peyton Hendricks, is able to trip him up there.
Interception returns it to the Warriors 45-yard line, 46-yard line. He's put down by 69, Peyton Hendricks. First down for the Warriors.
Number 69, Peyton Hendrick, old Shrek, is able to stop the Warriors from gaining any more yards on an interception. 27 seconds before halftime. Handoff.
Flips it off to number 7. He's up to the... Gets stuck right at the 38-yard line.
7 Shane Holden around the right side. Brought down by Alt and Howard. And Cowell.
Excuse me.
Out to the 58. Timeout.
Looks as if the Warriors called timeout, and we'll be right back after this short play. Once again, thank you for tuning in to RTC TV 4.
And last night, they defeated Oregon Davis 5-2. Soccer sectional draw was this morning, and the Comets will be playing in the second game of the tournament versus Rochester. That's the soccer sectional is here at the Crater starting the week of October the 3rd.
We are back. We got 21 seconds to go here in the second quarter before the half. Warriors called timeout, and looks like as if they're going to try to score here before the half.
Oh, they got to stop him. He's wide open out there.
20, 10.
Stop him.
And a touchdown. Wow.
18,
that's not good. That's going to put him 30, and that's zero. Obviously, we just might be trailing here a bit. Warriors setting up to get that extra point. And it's looking good from here. It's good down there, too. This is not looking good so far for us tonight. But I don't know. Hopefully we can recuperate over halftime and hopefully bring it back then in the second half. This just isn't looking too good so far here. With 11 seconds left to go on the clock. About ready to head off to halftime as the Warriors line up to kick the ball back off to the Comets.
Number Now it's the kickoff for the Warriors. Holt and Albright are deep for the Comets. If you haven't gotten there yet and you're in the homecoming activities, you need to get to the south end zone, please.
Nice kick by the Warriors. And he is open. Run it back. Run it back. That was a nice return by Casey.
For the Comets, it's our first and 10.
Oh, with 3 seconds left to go. Not even sure we can get a playoff here.
Three seconds to go here before the half.
Comets setting up.
Timeout on the group called by the Comets. Their third and final timeout.
Okay. Looks like a timeout on the field.
Once again, thank you for tuning in on TCTV. We'll be right back after this quick short break.
The JV volleyball team split their matches this week, losing to Manchester and defeating West Central.
Alright, and we're back with 3 seconds to go in the second quarter. Strange strategic call there to place a timeout at this point.
I don't know. They're looking for Conrad. That's what we intercepted.
Oh. Well, that's going to do it for the second quarter. Thanks all for watching RTC TV, and we'll be right back with you after halftime. Thanks again. Back, ladies and gentlemen, to RTC TV. We're just starting off the second half here. I'm Dakota Hayden and with Galen Rinsa here, in case you forgot. We are just getting back from this halftime.
And congrats to Carlos Estrada and Courtney Fry on becoming homecoming king and queen. So congrats to them. And the Comets start off with the squid kick as North Miami comes up with the ball.
Yeah, I don't know about those Courtney Fry and Carlos Estrada getting king and queen. They weren't who I voted for.
Well, Dakota, who'd you vote for?
Well, I voted for Mike Capone and Alyssa Ubenthal. That's who I voted for. I guess that didn't work out at all. Oh well, congrats anyway.
Ball replaced on the 32-yard line here as we start in the third quarter. Handoff play up to the 35. Picks up five on the handoff.
The Comets still trailing by 31. They need to turn things around here this second half.
Miles McDowell, Mark Smith.
I think we can do it.
Second down Warriors.
And I'll play once again. Might have picked up two on the game, on the play.
Possibly.
It's great. I'll have to say it's great to be here back at the Crater. I always love the stadium. It's always kept really nice. Don King does an amazing job, which is the announcer here. He does all the landscaping, and he does a really great job. So thanks to Don King for keeping the field looking really good.
And I do agree, it is nice to be home. It looks like North Miami's got to pick up the first down there. Weather's being pretty nice to us tonight. So far, it looks like clear, dark skies here. Not too chilly, which is good. Other than that, just a really good night to finish off this football
game.
Last
play. Looking, scrambling. He's
taking on the run. Open. Stop him. Sherrod Howard, as you see on the side, brings him down no matter what. He didn't want him getting out.
Yeah. I laugh at that type of stuff.
Yeah. Second down, Warriors. The handoff play. Brought down. 25 to cover the end on the carry. And Comets defense. Looking a little bit more awake here in the second half.
I can't tell if the Warriors stuck in some of the JV players, or I've noticed number 81, he's been in the whole game, so he's not a JV player. He's a full-time varsity player. So same with the quarterback, number 6 for the Warriors.
He's open. He's way out there.
He is fast. And he's up to the 18-yard line.
That kid's got to be a cross-country runner or something. He just goes,
maybe track or something.
Yeah, track sounds more likely. He just goes.
All right, these bugs are starting to get pretty crazy here. Just had one on my arm.
It's all right, we'll manage.
First down for the Warriors. Pass play, and that is complete. Fumble. Oh. And looks like they're calling it incomplete pass. Looks like a fumble because he actually, you know, caught it maybe for a second or two.
Seemed like he had possession of it.
Yeah.
Second down for the Warriors.
Ball is placed on the 17-yard line.
Second 10. Comets gotta keep the Warriors back. Looks like, oh, he dropped that. Went for a pass. And he is open. Look out of him go.
That would be a touchdown.
So, man, a touchdown for North Miami. This is not looking good. They're setting up for to get that extra point. Oh boy. The Comets really trailing here.
Yeah, they should have got the extra point.
And that is good.
That is looking good.
And now the Comets trail 37-38-0.
I'm not liking this.
Here in the third quarter with 9 minutes and 46 seconds to go. It's not looking really good. It's turned out to be as if the last, looking like the two last games, Pioneer and LaVille. Speaking of Pioneer and LaVille, they're actually playing tonight at the Pit at Pioneer.
They are, aren't they?
So I'm really...
I wonder how that's going, because aren't they both undefeated?
Yes, right now? They are both undefeated. I think the two top teams in the Class 1A, so.
Nice. That'll be an interesting game.
That will be a good game to go see.
North Miami setting up to kick the ball back to the Comets.
The Connor Hathaway to kick off the Warriors.
All right, 10
are deep for the Comets.
Nice kick by the Warriors.
Let's go,
Nice run there by Casey at number 40.
38-yard line. 39-yard line.
Thomas back on the offensive.
Yeah, looking.
Go ahead, Dakota.
Thank you.
That's fine.
Looking around the Bay here, it seems to be a pretty decent crowd for both teams here tonight. In fact, I don't think I've seen the stadiums this full since.
Yeah, same with the. The way team. I mean, there's a lot of people over there in the crowds, as you see.
Yeah.
Good show up here. I mean, it's homecoming, so I guess a lot of people come out for that. So, great support tonight. Too bad the Comets can't come up with anything so far.
Yeah.
56-man Stewart got up on the bottom of that pile for the Warriors. Second down Comets.
We'll see. Maybe they got something hidden up their sleeve that they're not just ready to use yet. Maybe a last resort or something.
Prepare the press box. If you're missing your cell phone, come check it out.
It's a handoff play.
40, KCL, straight at the middle. He's across the 45-yard line to about the 46.
That'll be a gain of yards. Nice. A gain is a gain. 3-3.
Those of you that care of interest, our financial show score, Pioneer and the world tonight. 21-7, Pioneer with 5 minutes left in the second quarter.
And it sounds like we got an update from Don King that Pioneer and LaVille game we were talking about. Looks like Pioneer's beating LaVille 21-7, I believe it was.
Yeah.
So that's pretty interesting.
That is interesting.
And
that run was a first down for the Comets. Nice. Yeah, 8 minutes left in the third quarter. If we can get something going here. Handoff. And he gets the hole in there. Ooh. He can run for days. Nice.
Hard hit there.
Casey also pointing to number 3.
Phoenix.
Phoenix Singleton coming for him. Looks like he got dragged down by the neck.
That's going to put another first down for the Comets. Nice run by Casey.
Pass play here.
Are you looking for the pass? He decides to run for it.
Pushing through.
That'll gain some yards.
Down to 33. Second down, Comets.
Now it's setting up for another offensive play going here. Looks like to be a handoff. Handoff to Phoenix is able to get some yards there. Nice run for Phoenix to put it up to the third down.
With 1 yard to go, 2 yards to go. Ball's placed on the 38-yard line. Hopefully the Comets can get something here, as they can continue this drive on offense.
We got a little bit of a momentum going here. Let's keep it going. Handoff. Number 3, Phoenix.
Brings up the first down.
Yeah, first down. Let's get sitting for the Comets.
Handoff play to
sights for a couple of yards.
Number 18.
Number
18.
That'll bring up second down for the Comets with 5 yards to go.
Just moving and grooving. Keep it going.
Pass play here. Brady's looking. Finds Tate Cowan. It's complete.
Great catch.
Let's see if the Comets can score here on this drive.
Let's go.
Nice. Setting up. It's going to hand off to Casey.
They're saying he's
going
down to the 2-inch line.
Oh, it's just so close. This is ridiculous.
All
right. He's right there.
Number
13,
Caston. 2 inches.
All right, we got 5 minutes remaining here in the third quarter.
Thomas better get this. Second and inches.
Let's see if they can get this. Goes for the quarterback sneak.
There's a quarterback sneak.
Oh, you gotta be kidding. Man.
This is getting ridiculous. On Comets. Sitting up here. Handoff to Casey.
Casey Fort fights in.
Is he?
I'm not sure.
Casey always looks as if he's talking quite a bit down there, as if he's really upset.
That's gonna bring up fourth down here for the Comets. This is 1 yard to go.
This is nerve-wracking. They're so close.
And as you see, the Comets call timeout. We'll be right back after this short break. Thank you for tuning in to RTC TV 4.
All right, welcome back. Fourth down here for the Comets, just 1 yard to go.
This is ridiculous. They're literally inches away.
Flag.
Let's hope that's not going to bring the Comets back.
What is that? Nice.
Nice.
This is ridiculous.
We're right there.
Quarterback sneak. Get him in. Is he in? I can't tell.
Outside, I think he's short. I hate to say it, but I think he is.
No.
No, it was QB.
You're joking.
No.
Casey all looks like he's coming up a little shaky there. Ankle maybe on the got hit. I'm not sure.
What is it?
Man. That has to be heartbreaking.
Are you serious?
They're right there.
That's just, it's terrible. Man.
Well, I guess that'll be turnover on downs, sadly.
Crap. That's the closest they've been all game, and they still couldn't get it.
I wish they would have, had Casey Hart running out, because, I mean, he's strong.
That might have at least just allowed him the few inches they needed to get in.
Yeah.
Striking. Second down for the Warriors. They're sitting on the 1 yard line. Flag on the play. About 3 minutes left in the third quarter. This just isn't good. Scramble.
Oh, he's wide.
And he's going to
throw it
down corner. He's wide out there.
Up to the 50.
This is ridiculous.
The 40. The 30. The 20. 10. All the way to East Houston.
All the way back. Oh my goodness. I got a hand to him, that was a good play. Gosh dang. Trail the comments back 44 now as the Warriors setting up for the extra point. Well, it's good.
Man, that's heartbreaking.
Man, I don't know what to think after that.
He's a little limping out there.
Yeah, it's Phoenix. He'll shake it off. Comets once again setting up to receive the kickoff from the Warriors. Setting up.
I see those people that are coming up with offers. Those do look good.
They do look good. I'm always a fan of the offers. Again, nice kick by the Warriors. Caught by number 40, Casey. He's on Casey's open.
Simpson, no! You see that little skip on that one over there?
Yeah. Setting up at probably about the, let's say, 47, 48 yard line, maybe.
Let's see if the Comets can get down there on this drive and actually score.
It'd be nice to get on the scoreboard at the very least. Sitting up there. The handoff, it looked like. Number 3, Phoenix, maybe. He's brought down. It's the second and eight for the Comets. Just 2 minutes left to go in the third. Still trailing by 45. Man, I can't get over that. Handoff number three, Phoenix. He's trying to push his way through there, and he's brought down. They're stuck with no gain. Nothing lost, nothing gained. Setting up. Looking like a pass. Brody looking. He's got no one out there. Flag is thrown. Flag thrown on the play. I think it might have been for holding.
On the defense?
Yeah. It was on the Comets. Things are not looking good here in the third quarter. We're just a little under a minute left to go.
We still have another fourth quarter to go.
And I'm just hoping that something comes out of there, but at this point it's not looking very likely. They go for the pass, number 17, Powell.
But, oh, it gets up to the
Looks up to the top. Put it on the fourth down for the Comets. At this point, you might as well just kick it back. I don't know what the Comets are planning here. I think they're going to run out the clock. And well, that's going to end it for the third quarter. Thanks again for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll be right back with you as soon as the fourth quarter starts. Thanks again.
Fourth down here to go for the Comets. with 15 yards to go.
Things looking real shaky here in the fourth quarter.
Pass play here, I'm guessing to Conrad. Yep, he's looking for Conrad. Just tosses
the pass to Conrad.
And almost intercepted. On the pass.
But Conrad didn't get there all the way far enough. Penalty called. Penalties refuse. Our Warriors take the offensive again.
Thanks for tuning in to CTV 4.
Still trailing by 45. The Warriors on defensive here. Hand off.
Yeah, that's where they're at. 25.
Actually, I think they just started doing that recently, the past 2 years.
Huh.
The football is better than last year. Last year was a bit windy. I had none of the worst was a pile of sticks with the three.
That's
right. Yeah. I'm sure.
No, honestly, I haven't really attended it.
I never went to a homecoming dance, honestly.
I don't either.
Well,
is it because they're saving money up for the prom?
It might be, because the prom's
in Chicago.
It might be.
I mean, I don't know where I am. Stop it. Sit and out.
Going back to the Warriors, I think so.
I don't think we'll go for it at this point. And they do go for it, which is kind of interesting.
Now.
Like as if everyone comes out and the JV team comes in.
Well, yeah, that's what's looking like what's going on. And their JV team really looks small.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that one looked very small out there. That might hopefully put us in the news to at least get on the scoreboard. as we enter about 9 minutes and 30 seconds into the fourth quarter. Second and 9 for the Warriors.
9 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter. That's the Warriors' lead, 25-0.
Hand off.
We're hit 2 fouls. This game's
Automatic
second down Cardinals.
Yeah.
sound over like hell in there, trailer. So if you're missing one, you can't get your car started to go home, you might want to run and check it out. So, slowly.
Thank you.